Harris Bullard was found dead in his study 5 days ago. Nobody believes me, but I think he was murdered. This house in the middle of nowhere holds the secret. There's a story hiding here, and I'm going to cover it. If I'm right, there are 4 major suspects. Graham Wellington, Josie Herrera, Cynthia Peckman, Bobby Sawyer. I'm not leaving until I find out what happened.
Thank you.
It might say reporter on my desk, but I spend most of my time at the Standard making coffee for my editor. I'm tired of writing the gossip column. This story is my shot at the big leagues. When I prove that Bullard was murdered, all the big papers will come calling. I'll finally escape this backwater town. This is it, the chance I've been waiting for. told me to cover Bullard's death, but he's just looking for gossip about the young assistant. But I took it seriously, did the research, followed every lead, like a real journalist would. It paid off. I found something everybody else missed. A note, a half-thought, scribbled in the margins of the coroner's draft report. It read, "Hypothermia in summer?"
Thank you.
Marguerite Higgins is my hero. She won a Pulitzer for her reporting in Korea. I went to college because of her. She goes to war zones, marches with the troops. Nothing scares her. And she gets the story. Marguerite Higgins doesn't run from a juicy story just because her life is in danger. Neither will I. Dad took me to Wichita once before he died. We drove for 4 hours to get there, ate hamburgers, and watched a movie. Then we went home. He never explained, just told me to get in the car. I guess he knew he was going to die. Woodcutter killed Bullard. He was pretty sneaky about it. No marks on the body, no sign of a struggle. Coroner ruled it was pancreatic failure. How do you kill a man without leaving a mark on him? And why return to the scene of the crime?
Thank you.
I haven't had a good night's sleep in 3 days. I've been giddy ever since I figured that this might be a murder case. Not even a broken arm could keep me down. But now that I'm here, the truth seems a lot more complicated. This story is my shot. Better make it count. Graham Wellington wanted fame and glory. Josie Herrera wanted to find something precious. Cynthia Peckman wanted money. Bobby Sawyer wanted to be a writer. I wanted to get out of Kansas and start a real life. Now I just want to see my mother again.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hypothermia. Kills in a matter of hours and leaves no mark. Bullard died in his freezer. Or was it James Lowry? Now that I've gathered all the pieces, I just need to put them together. A scientist with a past, a dead colleague, an ex-wife down on her luck. A girl with no father and a boy with no future. A snow woman. A full moon. Now I just need to get out of here alive.
Thank you.
I barely managed to pull Josie from the house as it burned to the ground. All of Bullard's research, his equipment, and his secrets burned with it. Josie Herrera was arrested for the murders of Harris Bullard and Graham Wellington. My story of blackmail, murder, and my narrow escape from a deranged killer made headlines. In January, I start at the Chicago Tribune. I never told them about James Lowry or that Josie's last name is really Turner. Those secrets are mine alone.